Hello and good morning. I am so excited this morning because I'm finally getting my household goods. Yes! 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 That was the weirdest sound. Yeah, so it's been 3 weeks since I have not had my things. I've been living out of my luggage bag, basically, and my wonderful air mattress, which I'm getting very accustomed to, surprisingly, but I do miss my nice mattress. Yeah, I was supposed to get my household goods like Monday, last Monday. Today is Tuesday. Today's Tuesday, yes. This is what happens when you're on 2 week quarantine at home. The hurricane slash tropical storm was coming through, so I think it got delayed slightly.
I just keep looking out my window, hoping that they'll arrive any minute now. Hello, is it me you're looking for?
Alrighty. Yep, still drinking out of my Taco Bell cup. Anyways, they're here, finally. The movers are here. They brought in the paperwork. Both of them aren't wearing masks, and even their paper says that they have to abide by the CDC regulations, and they're supposed to be equipped with the mask. Let's say I had something and I gave it to them, that's gonna be an issue. So he kind of was like, well, it's a little stuffy outside. Do you wanna be hot or do you wanna be in a hospital bed? He said he didn't have a mask, which is ridiculous. And you know, I shouldn't be the one that feels bad about it just because it's hot outside. That doesn't excuse people from possibly increasing the risk of exposing other people or getting it themselves. This is the reason why we're not progressing fast enough. I'm gonna have to care in it, man. I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. I'm not apologizing. This isn't something that should be an issue. It shouldn't be something I should bring up, especially with a moving company where they're going in and out of different houses. And I'm supposed to be on 2 week quarantine, making sure that nothing goes wrong. So I'm just gonna ask them nicely and hopefully it'll go fine. If not, it's gonna be an issue. So I know we talked about the mask situation. I would really appreciate if you guys wore masks just because I work in healthcare, so I take this pretty seriously. You don't have masks though, right? Okay, I can provide you with masks. Would you be willing to wear that? Okay, awesome. And then these are cool drinks if you guys want. Your sparkling water as well. Okay. Thanks, I appreciate it. It's everyone's responsibilities to help lower the risk so that we can get over this quicker. Even if it minimizes the risk a little bit, even by a tiny margin, to wear a mask, why not do it anyways? Because collectively, it's going to make a difference. Just unpacked everything. So yeah, they unwrapped everything, took all the boxes. They have the responsibility, if you want them to build everything back up. Since I had them build the patio furniture back, my bicycle, they built back my bookshelf, my desk, my clothing rack. Generally what happens is they bring everything in. And in the beginning, when I was in California, they were packing it, they put a sticker on all of the items, so 190. So when they bring it in, they'll call out a number, you go through the inventory, you initial next to 190 saying that you received it. As for claiming damages or losses, I have to pretty much go through my inventory, fill out this sheet, and follow the instructions there. The only things that I can see right now are my two garbage cans. Some dents here. Dents on this garbage can. I haven't unpacked the kitchen stuff yet, so hopefully the glassware is still intact, but we'll have to take a look. But overall, I am so happy now that I have been reunited with all my household goods. Now I can take the rest of this quarantine to just clean, organize, unpack, and just finally start to settle down. So I'm excited. Good morning. So it is day 3 of unpacking and I'm officially about 99% done. Again, my apartment does not have a recycling program, so I have to physically drive to a recycling center to drop these off. And wait, there's more. I am sweating like no other right now. As you can see, I am packed to the brim. I mean, I did the best I could. This is the recycling center closest to my area, and I guess it's better than throwing away all of that, especially the cardboard boxes. So I feel like, you know, it's the best effort that I could do.
I can't remember if I washed this uniform. I must have.
Make sure your creases stay where they need to stay and not get any other additional creases where you don't want. I always recommend getting some hangers like this that will keep your pants super straight like this. Okay, so all that's left to do is you put on your shoulder boards. These are the hard ones, and it's really easy. All you have to do is slip them through like so, and you button it. Little button. So those are done. Okay, so the last thing left to do is put on my service ribbons. There you go, this is the measuring gauge. Just got this off Amazon. And this is really nifty because it conveniently shows you a quarter of an inch and other measurements here. This quarter of an inch is perfect because that is exactly the height you're supposed to put your ribbons above your left breast pocket. So it should be parallel to the pocket, and that is perfect. It's a quarter of an inch all the way. I'm happy with how it looks. And just to make sure again, I'm just gonna take my handy dandy measuring gauge, quarter of an inch, quarter of an inch, quarter of an inch. Looks good. It's been a while since I've worn these, and I'm just kind of cleaning off the dust first. And I would recommend getting clear shoe polish, not like the white one, because that tends to make it kind of matte. But unfortunately, I ran out of the clear. It's kind of like a sponge applicator. All right, so uniform is ready to go for tomorrow morning. Shoes are polished.
Oh, also, this is awesome. Can you see how wrinkled this is? No wrinkles. Hi, good morning. It is officially Monday. My 2-week quarantine is officially over this morning. I am going to check in today at the hospital, and I'm going to meet my sponsor. A sponsor is someone you get assigned to before you PCS that has already been at the command. So they kind of help you check in, show you around, and introduce you to the clinic and things like that. Look, I have coffee, not in a Taco Bell cup anymore.
Upgrade.
Okay, so because my hair is so layered, I do have to braid it so that I don't have so many flyaways coming out of it. These are great. This bun ain't going nowhere, honey.
Alright, so this is the finished look. Time to put on my uniform. I forgot to attach my shirt stays last night, so these horrible things attach to your uniform, which then attaches to your socks so that this pretty much is pulled and tucked in tightly. But I hate these things because sometimes they pop off and it's just awkward. So I have to go head out now, and I'll see you back.
This is a habit I never had.
Hey guys, so I am heading back home now. I just left base. Oh my gosh, excuse me. Yeah, definitely not used to waking up this early.
In a quarter mile, your destination will be on the left.
No, that's not true. Not true at all. Got to tour.
Your destination is on the left.
No, it's not. No. Okay, let's see if I can get home without using the GPS. Oh, I think I can do it. I did most of my check-in process with my sponsor, so she's been here a little longer, and she kind of drove me around Bay, showed me where some of the different buildings were. Oh my gosh, it is such a big base. I'm just ready to get out of these summer whites because I'm pretty sure one of my shirt stays
already popped off, so that's cool.
Hi, so I just got home not too long ago, and today was my second day of the check-in process, and overall it has been going pretty smooth. I checked in around 0700 today, and I did a little bit of computer training in the morning, and then just kind of drove around base to different departments to get my other signatures. And then during lunch, was the best part, I went to the MCX, which is the Marine Exchange. On Navy bases, it's called the NEX, the Navy Exchange. And basically this is a pretty much like a big department store that's found on bases. And depending on the size of it, you can pretty much find anything. You can find makeup, skincare, apparel, shoes, electronics, cell phones. This one even had furniture and mattresses, which was pretty cool. And the best part is, it's duty free. That is such a plus, and usually they're a lot cheaper. I got this cute Kate Spade pajama set. I guess it's like a leave-in conditioner, so I'll probably use that after I wash up tonight. And a vitamin C serum, and of course, got these little acne patches because my nose has been acting up pretty recently with maskne. Just like really good things that have been happening is that I've been running into a lot of people, familiar faces, so it's such a small world, especially when it comes to military dentistry as well. It's like even smaller. I'm just kind of excited to see all these familiar faces and also make some new friends as well in the area. So that's been really good news. And for those of you that wear the type 3s with the black boots, I'm not talking about the coyotes. The bad thing about the black ones are that they can be kind of uncomfortable. And I do tend to get a lot of blisters, especially if I'm walking around all day like I am with the check-in process. But guess what? There's a product out there that I highly recommend. These have been such a game changer. This is kind of what it looks like. You slip it on and it covers pretty much the back heel. A lot of the times I will get a lot of blisters here, and what I'll do is I'll just, you know, pull my sock over it and then wear my boots like normal, and I haven't had an issue with it. I meant to show you another product that is similar in concept, except the silicone is actually built into the sock. I actually prefer these, but I actually only have one pair of these, whereas this one came in many packs. So I just kind of switch it on and off, but I just wanted to show you another option that works just as well. So there you go. Hey, how's it going? So it is day 3 of check-in, just making my way downtown. Down the list, going from place to place. So what I just did was checked in my loops. So FYI, for those of you that did the dental HPSP, they paid for your loops, right? But technically, because they paid for it, it is theirs. If you ever choose to separate from the Navy, you have to return them because it is the Navy's possession. So I got designs for vision in 2015. And another fact is that you can actually get new loops every 7 years though. They usually do provide you with at least a new light source, because I still have the old fashioned one where it's just kind of wired and you get all caught up in it sometimes. I think they're the Sparks by Orascoptic, so it's like the wireless ones where you just kind of tap it and turns on, but they don't have them in stock right now. So he told me that once they come in, that we will be notified for replacement. So yeah, that's just kind of like an FYI for you guys. So yeah, I'm just gonna continue with my check-in process. I still have about maybe like 7 places to hit. Hello, hello, just another update. I am currently parked at medical because it is raining a lot. It's okay, I have my umbrella though. So I am probably like 98 to 99% finished with all my check-ins. I believe I have maybe 3 more spots to hit and I should be wrapping this bad boy up. But so far it's fine. It's just this weather is kind of weird. Oh, I mentioned this in one of my HPSP videos, but like I said, I just dropped off my medical record. When you graduate from ODS, I do recommend that you take your medical and your dental records physically with you. It's not a huge issue if you didn't. It just takes a little more paperwork to make sure that they transfer it over, and then you gotta drop it off. But if you just have it with you, you just turn it in and you're good to go. So you don't have to worry about that. Hi,
Hi, and happy Friday! Yes, it is finally the weekend, and I am so excited. So it's been a little bit of a long week with the check-in process, but everything is out of the way, finished with the check-in sheet, so that has been great. Today we wrapped up by having a group meeting with the triad, which is the CO, the XO, and the Command Master Chief. So these are kind of the pinnacle of leaders in our battalion that run the show. So it was really nice to finally meet them in person. We got to introduce ourselves a little bit. Also, the CO is proudly a female, so it's always amazing to see a woman in a leadership position, so that is very inspirational. And I think this is a perfect time to end this vlog. If you've been watching to the end, thanks so much for your support. I really love making these vlogs because, number one, I just love video editing. And number two, it provides really small snippets in my life that I can one day reflect back on and just remember those memories. And of course, number three, for those that have been in my position, very new to the Navy, it's just a nice way to see kind of what's coming your way. So I hope it provided you a little bit of insight on what might happen with the transfer and PCS process. It's been a really good start so far, and I am ready to get that ball rolling and start patient care. Again, I always appreciate your support. Thank you for watching these videos, liking them, subscribing. If you have any other questions, you can always hit me up, or you can just drop them down in the comment section below, or if you just want to say hi, hello. All right, that's pretty much it. So I hope all of you guys stay happy, safe, and as always, stay flossy.